Knowing who you are. Knowing who you are. Being able to answer this question, who am I and what do I want? I'm not asking what are the roles that you play as a daughter, as a friend, as a sister. You're going to be a lawyer, you're going to teach, you're going to be a pharmacist. I'm asking the bigger question of who am I? Who am I really? My answer is I am God's child.
Who am I? Answering this question is not as easy as you may think. Throughout history, many scientists, authors, and spiritual individuals have contemplated this question, demonstrating that we are more than our bodies and minds by asking questions like, where do our thoughts really come from? This is what Bob Proctor and Oprah Winfrey have to say about who we are.
If you ask the average person who they are, they'll give you their name. They'll say, I'm Bob Proctor, but I'm not. Bob and Proctor are two words. My parents give them to me. They're called names, but it's not me. It's my name. Then somebody will say, well, this is me, but this isn't me either. It's my body. Okay. You know, we don't say am hand or am leg. It's my hand, my leg, my body, my name. Who am I?
I am that which is born of all that is. I am, as Pierre de Chardin said, a spiritual being having a human experience. Come trailing the breath of the ancestors, yet, but trailing the breath of the angels.
We're spiritual creatures. We have an intellect and we live in physical bodies.
Okay.
But because we lack awareness or understanding of who we are, we're totally locked into a physical world and we let things outside of us control us.
Today, we are going to focus on knowing who you are, which leads to self-discovery. In a future video, I will revisit the question, who are we as creatures, physically and spiritually? Feeling lost in life and self-discovery. Whether it's because of a major life event or just a sense of aimlessness, even with the challenges that the pandemic brought, many people have found themselves questioning their paths and searching for a sense of direction.
And often the advice I give to people today is fast forward where you are, look at yourself in 10, 15, 20 years time and ask yourself the question, is that where I want to be? And if the answer is no, then you need to find a new path.
If this sounds like you, you're in the right place. In this video, we are going to explore 10 essential questions that can help guide you back to your true self when life feels off course. Before we proceed, a warm welcome to those who are new here. Welcome to the Wayer Media channel, where we discuss life in general and how to navigate it by sharing personal experiences. As a friendly reminder, in my videos, I use psychology, movie scenes, online videos, books, and biblical verses to convey my ideas. If you don't agree with me on certain points, feel free to do your own research. I am merely an informative person, and my name is Abraham. On this channel, I am your host. Make sure to check out my previous videos after watching this one. Let's dive in. Question 1. Who am I? Let's start with the fundamental question. Who am I? Understanding who you are and what you want can be crucial in navigating life's uncertainties. This question can arise during various challenging phases, such as divorce, career changes, or shifts in life stages. It's an invitation to explore your inner self and your aspiration. The book The Purpose-Driven Life by Rick Warren outlines a 40-day spiritual journey that helps readers understand their purpose in life. It encourages individuals to live a life aligned with the divine intentions and values. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope in the future. Question 2. Who do I want to be? Moving on to our second question, who do I want to be? Sometimes figuring out who we are can be overwhelming. In such cases, asking who we aspire to become can provide clarity. This question can serve as a compass, guiding us toward our desired roles, both personally and professionally.
And What I know for sure is that the biggest choices begin and end with you. Your internal big questions. Who do I want to be in the world? My relationship to source energy, to all that is God. I'm not talking about what you believe in God. I'm talking about your experience of that which is all life, which is divine and universal. I'm talking about the big deal. Being connected and aligned with that. When you are tuned in and charged into that, whenever you feel empty, you go inside yourself and you connect to the source and you know that all things are possible.
The Road Less Traveled, it's a book by M. Scott Peck. This self-help book emphasizes the importance of discipline and personal growth. It encourages readers to confront and solve their problems through self-discipline and self-awareness.
Why are you trying so hard to hold on to the person you were before NZT?
That's who I am.
Well, it doesn't have to be. We become more different with every pill we take. You don't have to run from that. You can embrace it.
Then I want to be someone else.
I think you do. You're just not willing to admit it yet.
Question 3. How do I want to describe myself? Now, let's consider, how do I want to describe myself? It's crucial to identify the ideal version of ourselves and actively take steps to embody that vision. Whether it's about having an active social life, pursuing specific hobbies, or traveling the world, aligning our actions with our self-description is key to finding fulfillment.
So, Dave, tell us about yourself. Who are you?
Well, I'm an executive assistant at a major pet products company.
Dave, I don't want you to tell us what you do. I want you to tell us who you are.
Oh, all right. I'm a pretty good guy. I like playing tennis on occasion.
Also, not your hobbies, Dave. Just simple. Tell us who you are.
Maybe you could give me an example of what a good answer would be. What did you say?
You want Lou to tell you who you are.
I'm a nice, easygoing man. I might be a little bit indecisive at times.
Dave, you're describing your personality. I want to know who you are.
I don't know what the hell you want me to say. I'm sorry, I don't want to answer your question. Just not doing it right, I guess.
I think we're getting a picture.
Question 4. What truly inspires me? Moving forward, we ask, what truly inspires me? This question urges us to reflect on what excites us and makes us feel alive. If it's art, for instance, it's important to prioritize artistic endeavors in our lives, whether it's visiting galleries, taking up creative classes, or exploring new cultural experiences.
He's got a new guitar, he's gonna play a song.
Epic.
Great guitar requires a great song. Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Now it seems as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday. I said something wrong, now I long for yesterday.
Was that?
Yesterday.
That was one of the most beautiful songs I've ever heard.
The book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen R. Covey. This book is a renowned self-help classic that outlines 7 habits for personal and interpersonal effectiveness. It emphasizes principles such as productivity, prioritization, and continuous improvement.
You should make the building do that. They supposed to do
and
will do are two different things, Miles.
I'm an artist, man. I go to Bridgeview Arts.
Why aren't you in school?
I don't be doing all them everyday classes. You know, I got a special talent.
Yes, you do. It takes talent to make money. But it takes brains to keep it, Miles.
Question 5. What do I want professionally? Now, let's delve into the professional sphere with the question, what do I want professionally in my life? Our career can significantly impact our sense of purpose. If your job doesn't resonate with your true calling, it's crucial to invest time in self-reflection and explore alternative paths that align with your passions and values. In the book, The Artisan Soul by Owen Raphael McManus, this book delves into the concept of creativity and how it plays a significant role in human existence. It encourages readers to embrace their creativity and use it as a means of self-expression and purpose. Question 6. What do I want personally in my life? On a personal note, what do I want personally in my life can guide us towards nurturing meaningful relationships and connections with our loved ones. It's important to identify the areas that are lacking and take proactive steps to bridge the gap, whether it's through initiating family activities or strengthening communication. The 5 Love Languages book by Gary Chapman explores the concept of love languages, which are the ways individuals prefer to give and receive love. It helps readers understand their emotional needs and those of their loved ones. Question 7. What are my goals now? Moving on, what are my goals now? Prompts us to shift our focus from the how to the what. By envisioning our desired outcomes and truly believing in their realization, we can pave the way for their achievement.
You must have some kind of vision for your life. Even if you don't know the plan, you have to have a direction in which you choose to go. What I've learned is that's a great metaphor for life. You want to be in the driver's seat of your own life, because if you're not, life will drive you.
Remember, a clear vision coupled with consistent action can lead to tangible results. There is a book, Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. This motivational book explores the mindset and strategies needed for achieving financial success. It emphasizes the importance of having a clear vision, persistence, and a positive mental attitude. Question 8. What changes do I need to make? Sometimes, feeling lost can be a result of unhealthy habits or coping mechanisms. Therefore, it's crucial to ask, what changes do I need to make? Acknowledging the need for change is the first step towards a healthier and more fulfilling lifestyle. Surrounding ourselves with a supportive community can further aid us on this journey. The Power of Habit book by Charles Duhigg delves into the science behind habit formation and change. It provides insights into how habits work and how they can be transformed to improve one's life.
Without commitment, you'll never start. But more importantly, without consistency, you'll never finish. This ease is a greater threat to progress than hardship. Ease is a greater threat to progress than hardship. So keep striving, never give up, fall down 7 times, get up 8.
Question 9. Who is my tribe? Speaking of community, who is my tribe? Emphasizes the importance of surrounding ourselves with positive influences that align with our values and goals. Finding a supportive network can provide the necessary encouragement and motivation to pursue our aspirations. Question 10. What do I want my legacy to be? Finally, we ask ourselves, what do I want my legacy to be? This question encourages us to contemplate the mark we want to leave on the world.
I don't want to just be successful in the world. I don't want to just make a mark or have a legacy. I want to fulfill the highest, truest expression of myself as a human being. I want to fulfill the promise that the Creator dreamed when he dreamed the cells that made up me.
By aligning our actions actions with our desired legacy, we can live a more intentional and purposeful life. The book Tribes by Seth Godin. This book emphasizes the importance of community and leadership. It encourages readers to build and nurture their tribes, fostering a sense of belonging and purpose. So, there you have it, 10 questions to ask yourself when you're feeling lost in life. Self-discovery can be a transformative journey, and these questions can help you find your way.
We cannot escape the past. Some of us are doomed to repeat it. The cross you've been left to bear. A new day brings a new burden. The key is only the beginning. Wherever it leads, whatever it takes to get there, you'll have to do it on your own. So hurry. There isn't much time. The world doesn't know it, but they're counting on you.
Before we wrap up, remember the importance of being intentional in your life. It's easy to drift without a clear direction. But taking time to figure out what you want is essential for living an authentic and purposeful life. You can check out another video talking about how to find a purpose in life. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more valuable content. Thanks for joining us today, and remember, life is worth living when you know what you want. See you next time on Wear Media Channel.